Chaos cultists are the mortal servants to the Chaos Gods. They fight in swarms to overwhelm the enemy and may get a demonic blessing as a reward. Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we'll be showing you how to paint a Chaos cultist up to battle ready. Now, before we begin, we need to give him an undercoat, and as you can see here, I've used Grey Seer. Now, we'll be starting off with our base coats. Our first base coat is Gold Vorback Red for the red details, Lead Belcher for the silver details, Rune Lord Brass for the gold details, and Corvus Black for the black details. So let's get on with that red. So we're going to dip into the pot right here, and I'm going to pop it on our palette, and I'm going to just thin it down with a touch of water, just so we get a nice smooth consistency on our brush. And then we can start applying it to our model. So we're just going to apply it to the tabard here. That's our red detail on this Chaos Cultist right now. And you may need another coat just to make sure it's nice and smooth. So now that our red is dry, we're going to move on to Lead Belcher for our metal details. So I'm going to apply this to any of the leg plates and the armor panels and to the bolter as well. Now with the silver dry, we can move on to Rune Lord Brass for our gold details. So I'm going to apply this to all of the horn tips and around the faceplate, and he's got a little icon and belt buckle as well. And with the brass dry, we're going to move on to Corvus Black, and I'm going to use this for the black details such as the gun casing and the hood. With this paint, you may need a couple of coats. With those dry, we're going to move on to the rest of our base coats. For these, we're going to use Mechanicus Standard Grey for the grey details and Doomball Brown for the brown details. So let's get on with that grey. So I'm going to take it out of the pot like last time. I'm going to thin it on the palette just because it's a bit thick and gloopy. And I'm going to get a brush to a nice point before putting it on the model. So for this, I'm going to apply it to the trousers, and you can apply it to any wraps as well around the weapons. Now that the grey is dry, we can move on to the Doomball Brown for the brown details. So I'm going to use this on the horns and the leather details like the straps and the boots. With our base coats dry, we now can move on to some shades and contrasts. We'll be starting off with Dark Oath Flesh for the skin tone, followed by Basilicarnon Grey for the grey and red details, Agrax Earthshade for the gold and brown details, and a Nuln Oil for the black and grey details. So let's get on with the Dark Oath Flesh. So we're going to dip it out of the pot. We're not going to thin it down, so we're going to use it straight from the lid of the pot. Make sure our brush is nice and pointy as well. And then we can apply it straight to the model. So we're going to just apply it to all of the chest areas and the arms and the hands. And we're going to make sure it doesn't pool in too many areas. If it does, don't worry. Just take a dry brush, and then you can just soak it up to make sure it doesn't pool into the areas down below. Now that the skin is done, we can move on to the Basilicarnon Grey, and then we're going to put that all over the silver and the red cloth. Now that Basilicarnon Grey is now dry, we can move on to Agrax Earthshade, and we're going to apply that all over the brown and gold details. Now that is dry, we can move on to the Nuln Oil, and we're going to apply that over the black and the grey areas. Now that our shades and contrasts are now dry, we can move on to the base of the model. For this, we'll be using Astrogranite and our trusty texture tool, and let's get started. So I'm just going to grab the pot gently so we don't tip it over. I'm going to use the wide end of the scoop, and I'm going to scoop a little bit out, like so, and then I'm going to put it on the base. So I'm just going to be gentle, and I'm going to just make sure that I don't get on any of the model itself. I'm going to use the small end for this now. I'm going to push it around just so it's not too thick and heavy. If you want to build up the layers afterwards, just apply a little bit more in some of the wider areas, and then you can create a bit of depth. And now that our texture is dry, and the rim of the base is painted in Abaddon black, our Chaos Cultus is now complete. And there you have it. Our Chaos Cultus is now battle ready to overwhelm the enemy and die in the name of Chaos. By following these methods and techniques, you can easily apply them to any models in your collection. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own Chaos Cultists, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye!